This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. Now, there are different ways to define the trig functions, and one of the first ways I defined it in my videos was using this definition. If xy is any point other than the origin on the terminal side of an angle theta in standard position, and r equals the square root of x squared plus y squared, then the sine of theta is y over r, cosine of theta is x over r, the tangent of theta is y over x, etc. And of course, we have to make sure no denominator is zero. So here's an example. Here is an angle theta in standard form, happens to be in quadrant 1, but it could be in any quadrant. And so we see the length r here. That's how far it is, the distance from the origin to this point xy, which is some point on this terminal side of the angle. Okay, and given that, we've got values for x, y, and r that we could use to define any of these six trig functions. Now, what would happen if r was 1? So that's what we're going to explore today. What if r equals 1. So in other words, what if I choose this ordered pair xy so that r is equal to 1? Well, if you put in 1 for r for the sine of theta, you'd have y over 1, which means it's just y. If you put in 1 for r for the cosine of theta, we would have x over 1, which means it would be equal to x. It wouldn't change the tangent or the cotangent because r isn't involved at all. But for the cosecant, if r was 1, the cosecant would simply be 1 over y, and the secant would be 1 over x. So this leads us to a new definition called the unit circle definition. And this definition is useful when we're going to start graphing trig functions. So if theta is an angle in standard position whose terminal side intersects the unit circle at x equals 1. All right, so what's the unit circle? Remember, the unit circle means r equals 1. All right, so in the unit circle, r equals 1. All right, so now we've got theta in standard position, but it intersects the unit circle at xy. So here's a picture right here. Down here on the left, I have a unit circle, and I've got some angle theta, but I'm going to choose the point for xy right here. It's on the unit circle, as opposed to any point on that terminal side of the angle. Then, the sine of theta is simply y, the cosine of theta is simply x. The tangent and cotangent are defined exactly the way it was in the previous definition. The cosecant of theta is 1 over y, and the secant is 1 over x. And again, we have to make sure the denominator is not 0. So, this ordered pair xy, if you look at the picture on the left here, well, what is x according to this? X is the cosine of theta, right? See right here? So I could replace x with a cosine theta, and I could replace y with a sine of theta. So I could write this ordered pair as xy, or I could write it as cosine theta, sine theta. So this is kind of interesting here. If you have an angle in standard position, and you're going to choose a point that intersects the unit circle, that x value, that x coordinate, is the cosine of theta, and that y coordinate is the sine of theta. So how could this definition make sense if we were looking to find the cosine of 30 degrees and the sine of 30 degrees? Now, of course, we know what the cosine and sine is from other methods. We could certainly just draw a right triangle and see it. So let's think about this. If I knew the coordinates of this ordered pair right here, okay, the first coordinate would be the cosine of 30 degrees, and the second coordinate would be the sine of 30 degrees. All right, well, how about if I just kind of look at this triangle? Okay, I could see that is a 30, 60, 90 triangle. right? And you know in the 30, 60, 90 triangle, let's see, if the short side is 1, the hypotenuse is 2, and this is square root of 3. But of course, I need that this length here from the origin to this ordered pair where it intersects the unit circle has to only be 1 unit, not 2 units. Well, there's a little trick here. This is just we could just think about similar triangles. In other words, in a similar triangle, you can take and multiply or divide all the sides by the same number, and you will have a similar triangle. So the same ratios could be used. So if I do that, if I divide each of these by 2, what happens? I'd have 2 over 2. I'd have 1 over 2. And I'd have the square root of 3 over 2. And this would give me this length of 1 right here. So 30 degrees still. So that means if I try to figure out what this ordered pair is, it's saying this little length right here, the x direction, is square root of 3 over 2. So this is square root of 3 over 2. That's that x coordinate. And the y coordinate, you'd be going up 1/2 space. Look at the picture and see if that makes sense. Is that like about halfway up? You know, here's all the way up to 1, right? Can imagine that's about half. So the y coordinate certainly, hopefully to you, looks like that makes sense. So once we have that ordered pair, we know that ordered pair here, that tells us that the x coordinate is the cosine and the y coordinate is the sine. So the cosine of 30 degrees equals square root of 3 over 2, and the sine of 30 degrees is 1/2. And that agrees with everything we've done thus far using other methods to find the cosine of 30 degrees or the sine of 30 degrees. Now, the same idea could be used to figure out the coordinates of any of the special angles all the way around this circle. So for 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, if you take the hypotenuse, whatever it is, and divide all three sides by the whatever that number is for the hypotenuse, you would end up getting r equaling to 1. So you would see what it is on the unit circle and be able to figure it out. Now, you don't need to use this to figure out the cosine and sine of 30 degrees. It's just that it's a fact that if you did have all those ordered pairs on the unit circle, you would easily be able to tell what the cosine or sine of any of those special angles are. All right, what we have here is all the values filled in on a unit circle. I'll show you how to fill these values in, but for now, let's say you did do this. I'm not suggesting you need to, but notice here's 30 degrees, which is pi over 6 in radians, and I've got square root of 3 over 2, 1/2 is the ordered pair, so this would just tell me that the cosine of 30 degrees is square root of 3 over 2, and the sine of 30 degrees is 1/2. How about the sine of 225 degrees? If I locate 225 degrees on this circle, I see this ordered pair. Negative square roots of 2 over 2, negative square roots of 2 over 2. So the sine of 225 degrees is simply the y value, negative square roots of 2 over 2. How about the cosine of 270 degrees? Is this ordered pair right here. 0, negative 1 is what we want to look at. And the cosine would be the x coordinate, so 0. So the cosine of 270 degrees is 0, etc. So if you did have this is like a cheat sheet here. If you did have this, you could easily see the cosine or sine of any of the special angles. Personally, if I wanted to know the trig function of a special angle, I simply draw a right triangle and figure it out from there each time, okay, rather than make this entire table up just so I could read an x-coordinate or a y-coordinate. But anyway, the usefulness of this will be more apparent on my next video, because we're going to be talking about the circular functions, which is just related to this circle right here, and it's a little bit, you know, more obvious why you would possibly want to understand what these ordered pairs are on this unit circle. And I'll also show you how you could fill in these x and y coordinates using a little trick. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.